I have a lot of friends yang practice polygamy. A lot of friends that have 3 wives, 20 children, blah blah blah. And the I need to make my own podcast about this whole title, polygamy, because it's a very interesting discussion where, unfortunately, in this world, a lot of people portray the bad side of polygamy. Maknanya ramai orang tunjuk keburukan poligami lah. Banyak buruk dia. Banyak. That's why dalam Islam, dia cakap, only do it if you mampu. Perkataan mampu tu means a lot of things.
Yeah.
Not just mampu segi wang, mampu segi perasaan, segala macam. Kita ada kucing, kita ada favourite. Ada favoritism, ada yang kita lebih sayang, ada yang kita kurang sayang. Sama juga kalau kita ada 2 isteri. Mungkin isteri yang pertama ni, whatever lah, dia akan ada 2. Tetapi sebenarnya ini pendapat saya. Kalau I'm not menggalakkan lah, pendapat saya ialah sebenarnya manusia mampu untuk sayang lebih daripada seorang. Tapi di mana mistake dia ialah orang fikir dia berkongsi. There's no such thing. Maknanya contoh kan, if you are my husband, I will love you 100%, and my second husband also I will love 100%. It's not half-half. So bila Papa cakap I tak nak berkongsi, you tak berkongsi pun, dia tetap akan sayang you sepenuhnya. Okay, so to me, polygamy is a beautiful way of life. And dalam orang putih cakap, open relationship.
But that's not polygamy, right?
Yes,
polygamy
it,
is you have to marry lah.
Open relationship, it comes from polyamorous. It's a polyamorous life.
Tapi open relationship lain, yang tu you tak payah kahwin. You just,
I yeah, have to tapi you. The whole thing comes from polyamorous lah. Dalam Islam, polygamy lah sebab dia secara halal. Open relationship tak halal, kan?
Tak halal lah, betul.
But dalam, contoh, you all will be surprised. Saya pernah dilamar oleh isteri-isteri untuk jadi isteri kedua.
What?
Yes. Dan saya juga pernah dilamar oleh anak-anak, Papa, kahwin dengan auntie ni. Auntie ni wrong. Kita nak dia jadi mak kita orang yang baru. Saya pernah dilamar. It's not weird. Saya ada ramai kawan-kawan baik saya, Syum macam di madu aku. Because orang dah mula faham, poligami sebenarnya indah. Okay, I bagi example lah.
Please give an example, yeah.
Katalah laki kau ni, okay, we have to go to the kelambu thing eh.
Okay.
Okay, one of the main reason why lelaki dibenarkan poligami, kalau nafsu dia tinggi, kalau dia hanya ada one wife, penat isteri dia, tak terlayan. So kalau dia ada madu, bolehlah bergila-gila. itu benar. Ramai orang berkahwin untuk itu.
Yeah.
Sebab nafsu dia tinggi. So, one woman is not enough for him. Dia kena kahwin lagi. So, dia boleh seminggu sekali cukup. Macam tu.
Is that the only reason for polygamy?
No, that's one of the reasons.
Okay,
another reason why I ada banyak girl yang ajak I jadi madu dia orang, because they love me so much. It's like, suami dia busy dengan kerja dia kan? Macam mana kita pergi main bowling, kita pergi karok dengan madu sendiri. So, I ada ramai kawan yang ada 2 wives, 3 wives. Dia orang memang geng kot. I suka tengok rumah tangga dia orang.
Anti-anti Kia?
Entahlah. Nah, I mean, the madu-madus are actually besties and they go out watching movies together. They look after their kids together. It's a very happy institution. Cuma orang tak gembar-gemburkan ini. It's my job. Let's make a movie. You know, actually polygamy cantik kalau you do it the right way.
Okay.
The most important is the right way.
But yeah. is it possible for a man to love 4 women equally?
Definitely. Not equally, but 100% for all. Equally tak lah.
Tak faham. If you love 100% all, then it's equal, right?
Not really. There's
not
a
really.
Favorite.
There's still
always a favorite.
You don't have a favorite. Even correct me
like
if I'm wrong, Rasulullah sendiri ada favorite wife.
Like a side chick.
Tapi doesn't mean he's not nice to his other wives.
Yeah.
Okay.
Dia masih sayang.
Dia mesti ada sebab kita pun, okay, saya ada banyak anak patung. Mesti saya ada favourite.
Okay.
Tapi, I sama rata je dengan semua orang. Kadang-kadang I bawa yang lain, bawa yang lain.
Okay. But if you were the first wife, wouldn't it be difficult for you to accept? Because it's sort of like I'm getting a replacement or somebody.
No. They don't replace you.
Okay.
They take a burden off.
But correct me if I'm wrong, but in Islam, if I want to marry a second or third wife, I need to get the approval of the previous wives, right?
Depends on the country.
Oh, depends on the country. So here, Malaysia, do I need to?
Recently, they said no.
Oh, okay, no.
Dulu ya, bukan kau baru-baru ini kata tak payah?
Okay, so no, you don't need to.
We have to recheck that on segi undang-undang Islam lah, because there is a difference with undang-undang agama dan undang-undang negara.
Civil then.
Dia ada dua.
Syariah, okay.
Tapi actually by right tak perlu.
Okay.
Kalau dia mampu segi, okay, saya okay berbalik pada my friends. Saya ada seorang kawan, he's a businessman. Dia ada 4 isteri. 4 isteri dia bekerja. So masing-masing ada kerjaya. Kemudian dia ni very smart. Nama dia Mahir. Hai Abang Mahir. So Mahir ni memang Mahir lah. Nama dia Mahir. Dia telah membeli rumah di kawasan yang sama. Di sini. Di Damansara Damaisri Damansara. Sebuah rumah untuk isteri pertama. Kedua, semua duduk apartment masing-masing dekat. Okay. So semua kerja. So segi wang banyak eh. Dia businessman, bini dia kerja. Anak ramai, whatever, they all live dekat. Senanglah dia nak pergi gile-gile. Tak jauh pun. And then they always have picnic-picnic together. Best.
Ni kalau nak pergi kampung. It does sound very nice when you say it.
It does. You all, kita kena buat dokumentari kan.
Nak balik kampung ni jam kampung siapa nak balik.
Tapi kan, I nak cakap something, you all jangan marah tau. Dalam Islam tak dibenarkan. I will tell you kenapa tak dibenarkan. Tetapi kalau perempuan boleh kahwin 4, I selalu cakap berapa? I would be the first woman. Tapi sebabnya kenapa perempuan tak boleh, satu je. Sebab nanti kita tak tahu bila dia mengandung, anak tu anak siapa.
That's true.
So
that's
true. Kalau perempuan ada 4 suami, sebenarnya I punya kepercayaan, semua orang boleh. Laki pun boleh sayang lebih, perempuan pun boleh sayang lebih. Tapi kenapa perempuan tak boleh? Kang sudah. Siapa punya anak? Kang dua-dua telur bercantum dah 2 bapa pula. Susah tu.
Damn.
It does happen, right? In science.
I mean, it does.
It does. So, whoops.
No worries.
So women cannot do that?
Yeah, they can't. Yeah.
Sadly. Can I have 4 wives?
Husbands? Does polygamy interest you?
Does polygamy interest you,
Luffy? I have no idea.
Are you a one-woman man? Or are you I have enough love for everyone.
I think I'm a love for everybody.
I've proven my point. But kalau you tanya 100 lelaki, I think peratus dia nak polygamy lagi. Oh my god.
I think it's beautiful.
It is
very beautiful.
Sayang.
Sayang.
It is beautiful. If you can get that kind of marriage, tapi make sure buat betul-betul lah. Sebab kalau polygamy macam secara rahsia, tak bagi tahu, and then life is hard.
Jangan.
Itu janganlah.
A proper polygamy is nice.
Janganlah.
And it's more meriah, it's more merrier.
Yeah. You bayangkan the my girlfriends yang nak ajak I jadi madu kan? That's good.
Yeah.
I mean, kita dah ngam. And then kita get married, aku nak cemburu dengan dia pun tak payah. We are best friends.
Yeah.
Yay. Tapi no, polygamy doesn't mean korang pergi buat threesome tau. Tak boleh, eh?
No.
Not allowed. That's not allowed.
Yeah, it's not allowed.
It's not allowed in Islam. Sebab tak boleh. Bukan benda tu private.
Yeah.
Perempuan dengan perempuan pun ada batas-batas dia. Dia private. Tak boleh tunjuk. So tak boleh, eh?
Tak boleh, okay.
Jangan, eh? Thanks. Jangan,
thanks.
Eh?
Thanks for letting me know. I'll keep this in mind.
Jangan, sebab ada orang yang berkahwin duduk serumah tak boleh, eh?
Okay.
Yang ada 2 isteri, dia tak boleh serumah.
Okay.
Sejauh mana engkau tiba-tiba tak bawa yang lagi seorang masuk bilik kau? Jangan, ya. Tidak.
Okay. Malam ni malam I, ya.
Tak boleh, ya.
We can't
Tapi,
share.
Seperti yang kawan saya buat, semua orang punya rumah berdekatan, itu menarik. Wah, tak payah jauh-jauh.
Tak pun ambil nombor.
Bini yang pertama nak beranak, giliran bini kedua, jap. Okay, pergi sana kejap. Semua dekat.
Oh my God.
Nak try? Dia pun duduk sini, though. And ayah dia lagi sama kawan, sama juga. Dia duduk sini juga. Dululah. Pun bini-bini dia duduk sini juga.
Wow.
So that's a good idea, kan?
I mean, being married, oh my goodness, one wife is enough.
I can't think of one more.
Yeah, tapi, one more to go. No, but I think maybe, and I could be wrong, I think this will work in a Malay community because of the cultural differences.
Okay.
I do, because I think it works well in certain communities, because certain communities, the women are more against it. Like I always tell my wife, because she's Chinese, right? So I know Chinese people who have they have like 2-3 wives.
Okay.
But not legally lah.
Dulu lah. Oh, okay.
Not legally lah. Satu memang legal, satu is you marry outside lah.
Okay. Oh, ada such thing
eh? Yes.
Di masa kini?
Masa kini.
Okay.
Or they have another concept where they have
mistress.
But the thing is, they accept it.
Okay.
If
so
you
that's an open relationship.
Open relationship. But no, but it's sort of like a polygamous relationship because everybody knows.
Correct.
And the wife
knows.
So
that's actually beautiful, right?
It is, but I don't think in the Indian culture it will work.
Oh, India tak boleh.
Oh, I think. Ah, I think Indian
when it comes to this, it's like when it's private, it's private, private.
Yeah.
I think it tak ada kena dengan race kot. Orang terhadap orang tu kot.
Maybe.
Hmm, kalau dia jenis individual. Boleh, macam I boleh je. Okay. I'm okay with that. And siapa-siapa nak bermadu dengan aku, okay, raja-raja. I'm okay with that. Not everybody is okay with
this
that, betul.
This has become like a matchmaking episode. So tell us, what are you looking for?
We are available.
Nombor dia dekat
bawah. Dia ada.